Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study the hexadecimal multiplication. In this tutorial we are going to learn how to multiply two hexadecimal numbers directly without converting to any another base. Consider this example given to us where we are going to multiply FA to the base 16 to 12 to the base 16. So I'll write this given numbers as it is into the solution part. We'll write our answer into this text box. Now, what is F in hexadecimal and what is A in hexadecimal? As we know, the base of the hexadecimal number system is 16 and the valid digits are 0 to 15, where we are going to use 0 to 9 all digits, and 10 is represented by A, 11 is by B, and so on till F is represented, 15 is represented by F. So we'll see what is F. F is called 15 in hexadecimal, so I'll write 15 here. What is A? It is 10, so I'll write 10 here, multiplied by 1 into 2. So we are going to use the same rule of multiplication of two numbers the way we multiply two numbers in decimal number system. So it means that we are going to multiply all these digits by the first digit of the second number, that is 2 in this case. So I will first multiply 2 by 10. 2 by 10 is 10 into 2 is 20, but I will not write 20 here as it is. We have to convert 20 into hexadecimal number system. What is the hexadecimal equivalent of 20? To convert 20 into hexadecimal, we will follow this procedure. We will divide the number 20 by 16 and then we will get it. Quotient is 1, remainder is 4. When you divide this 1, you will get quotient as 0, remainder 1 as it is. To get the exact hexadecimal equivalent, we have to arrange this remainders from bottom to top. So 1 4 is the hexadecimal equivalent of 20. Therefore, 20 in hexadecimal equals to, so 20 in decimal equals to, it is 1 4 in hexadecimal. Out of this 1 4, I will write 4 here, and 1 will be given as carry to the next step. Now we'll multiply this 2 with 15. 15 into 2 is 30. 30 plus 1, this carry is 31. 31, it is in decimal. We have to convert it into hexadecimal. When you do that, you will get quotient as 1 here and remainder is 15. Right. Again, you divide this 1 by 16, you will get quotient as 0. This remainder as 1 as it is. So when you arrange it from bottom to top, you will get 31 in decimal is equals to 1. What is it? 15 in hexadecimal, it is F. 15 is equivalent to F. So I'll write 1F as the answer in hexadecimal. So this is the last digit in this multiplication. So I'll put this 1F as it is here in the answer. Then for further multiplication to the next digit with the other numbers, I will multiply now 1 with these digits. So I'll get 1 into 10 is 10, 1 into 15 is 15 as it is. And we will perform addition now. We will perform addition of these two according to the hexadecimal addition rules that we have studied in our previous tutorial. Now 4 plus 0 is 4. Now this F plus 10, what is F? F is 15. 15 plus 10 is 25. 15 plus 10 is 25, which is greater than the last valid number of this hexadecimal number system, that is 15. 15 was the last number of this system. So whenever the sum of two digits exceed 15, we need to generate a carry to the next step. So this is the carry here, say. Now we'll add this 1, 15 and 1. So it becomes 15 plus 1 is 16 plus 1 is 17. Final answer is 17. As you see, 17 is also greater than 15, last valid number. So we need to generate a carry to the next step. We'll copy this one as it is, because there are no further digits for addition. At last, in the result, if you have any invalid digits, hexadecimal digits, are there any invalid hexadecimal digits into this final result? Yes, it is 7925. These two are invalid hexadecimal digits. So we need to subtract the base of the system, that is 16, from each hexadecimal invalid digits. That is 7925 are invalid. So I will subtract 16 from 7925 to get our actual result of this multiplication. So the result is, here it is 4, 25 minus 16 is 9, 17 minus 16 is 1, and this 1 as it is here. So this is our actual answer of this multiplication. I will write it here, 1, 1, 9, 4. Therefore, we can say that FA to the base 16 into 1, 2 to the base 16 is equals to 1, 1, 9, 4 in hexadecimal. So this way, we can perform multiplication of any two hexadecimal numbers directly without converting to any another base.